Today is Monday, November 6th. In today's news service, we'll cover the French president's provocative new initiative that has sparked controversy among Christians. We'll also discuss German bishops who have spent 12 years writing a manual on how to avoid abuses in the church. Additionally, we'll contemplate the effect of video messengers that, according to some scientists, dull our brains. We also remember the Polish bishop who helped raise millions to save a sick girl. And finally, we'll talk about the release of a new song that's sure to lift the spirits of even the most discontented. Welcome to the Safira Radio News Service.
Pope Francis has called on charismatic Catholics to expand their evangelization at a Vatican conference attended by nearly 4,000 participants. He recommended organizing seminars in various places, especially among the poor and on the outskirts of cities and towns. He emphasized that the gifts of the Holy Spirit should serve the entire church and encouraged promoting rather than controlling them. In conclusion, he called for prayers for the Middle East and reminded of the importance of peace and reconciliation.
The Gospel Future Forum, organized by the World Evangelical Alliance in Istanbul, brought together participants from 61 countries. Discussions on the future of Jesus' mission and care for creation covered a wide range of topics, from neurotheology to environmental stewardship and cultural influence. New working groups and initiatives emerged in anticipation of the Church's bicentennial celebrations in 2033.
A representative of the French Episcopal Conference criticized President Macron's plan to enshrine the right to abortion in the Constitution. He pointed out that France is experiencing an increase in abortions compared to other European countries and warned against shutting down public debate. Archbishop Pierre Dornelia expressed concerns that incorporating abortion into the Constitution could limit freedom of speech and debate on the subject and overlook other issues like poverty. He also raised the matter of a conscience clause for healthcare workers.
German bishops have published a guide addressing spiritual abuse. Bishop Heinrich Timmerevers led the editorial team. The document, 12 years in the making by a commission, aims to help victims understand and process their experiences and deal with trauma. Timmerevers noted the complexity of creating the guide due to the need to consider diverse church community experiences. It also instructs clergy on proper pastoral care and trains leaders to respect the spiritual autonomy of the faithful.
Bishop Damian Muscus continues his relentless action. Thanks to his attitude and community engagement, 10 million zloty were collected for the treatment of a girl suffering from spinal muscular atrophy. Previously, the bishop, as a volunteer, performed gardening work while donors organized fairs, bazaars, and auctions to support the fundraiser. The girl's parents thanked everyone for the support and numerous charity events that lasted for months.
Yale scientists have found that conversations via video communicators engage the brain differently than face-to-face meetings. Research using PhenIRS, EEG and eye tracking showed that direct interactions stimulate the brain more robustly and provide more stimuli, reinforcing the benefits of personal contact in line with the brain's natural social predispositions.
Ted Wilson, president of the General Conference of Seventh-day Adventists, stressed the Bible's role as the inspired word of God and the foundation of faith. He recalled the principle of using the historical grammatical method for interpreting scripture, which allows the text to explain itself. He warned against interpretive methods that undermine the authority and inerrancy of the Bible. Wilson encouraged daily prayer and Bible study, seeking guidance from the Holy Spirit.
Christian musician Kirk Franklin releases The Single Needs, a blend of soul and Armstalti, with a modern urban church choir sound. In the dynamic track, which Franklin describes as a personal conversation with God, he conveys messages of strength, hope, and the need for spiritual support amid life's challenges. Needs invites joint prayer and seeking support in faith, offering hope to those in need. It encourages sharing faith and love with others. The song is available on all major streaming platforms and will be aired on our station in just a few moments.
That's all for today's edition of Safira FM's news service. Have a great week and may God bless us all.